Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh, brothers and sisters. Okay, welcome again to my YouTube channel. So today we continue our reading study. We learn Arabic through reading text. This is in Arsbiyyah Bayna Yadayk, Book 1. This is about an-nas wal amakin, about people and places. Okay. I read first the text, and then next I will provide the translation and also explain the grammar. Okay, so you will know how to read and how to pronounce, and also the translation and some grammar. Okay, let's begin. Abdul Aziz Talibun Kiniyun Hadara min Kinia Lidirasati Fi Jami'ati Ummil Qura Fi Makkah al-Mukarramah يدرس عبد العزيز اللغة العربية والثقافة الإسلامية. عبد العزيز يحب مكة ويقضي الوقت صباحا في الجامعة ويصلي العصر والمغرب والعشاء في المسجد الحرام. Okay, so now let's learn the details sentence by sentence. Okay, this is the first sentence. Abdul Aziz is the name of person, is a man. Talibun, student. Kiniyun, Kenyan. So Abdul Aziz is a Kenyan student. Talibun Kiniyun. Okay, the grammar. Abdul Aziz, and then in Arabic there is no to be. Abdul Aziz Talibun. Abdul Aziz is a student. Okay, this is the construction of Mubtada and Khabar. Talibun. Talibun. Kiniyun is the adjective of Talib. So must be the same. Because Abdul Aziz is masculine, a man. So Talibun is masculine. And Kiniyun is also masculine. Okay. Okay, next sentence. Hadra min Kinya lidirasati fi jami'ati Ummil Qura fi Makkah al-Mukarramah. Hadra, he came. Hadra ya means he came. This is past tense form. Min, from Kinya, from Kenya. Lid di rasati li for, this is harf jar, so that's why di rasati kasrah ending lid di rasa, but you don't need to pronounce, just say lid di rasa. Fi is also harf jar, so jamiati becomes kasrah jamiati. Fi jamiah Ummil Qura. Why Qura, not Kuri or Kuru? Yeah, this is isim ghairu munsharif. Actually, it must be kasra because after harf jar, or is also the position here is also mudaf ilaih. So must be kasra actually, but because this is isim ghairu munsharif, isim ghairu munsharif must be fathah, never take kasra. And then fi harf jar kata, not makati, because this is also isim ghairu munsharif. Fi makkata, or just say fi makkah. Fi makkatal mukarramah. Okay, al mukarramah, why kasra al mukarramati? Because it is mudhaf ilaih. Okay, you can learn the formula of idofa, mudhaf and mudhaf ilaih, in this channel. Fi makkatal mukarramah, he came from Kenya for study in Ummil Qura Jami'ah University in Makkah al-Mukarramah. Okay, next. Okay, don't forget to subscribe my channel and share this video. Okay, we continue the study. Yadrusu Abdul Aziz al-Lughat al-Arabiyyah wa al-Thaqafat al-Islamiyyah. Or you can connect Abdul Aziz al-Lughat al-Arabiyyah. Okay. Okay, the translation. Yadrusu. This is present tense form. Yadrusu means he studies. Okay, the word year is the pronoun of he. Okay, Yadrusu means he studies. Abdul Aziz. Okay, this is the subject. This is verbal sentence in Arabic. Jumlatul fi'liyah begins with verb. Abdul Aziz is the subject. And we also add attached subject, ya. Abdul Aziz, ya drusu. Okay, so it means Abdul Aziz studies. Okay, and then the formula there, Abdul Aziz, Abdu, why not Abdi? Okay, Abdul Azizi. It's the name of person actually. It means of the slave of Al-Aziz, the names of Allah. Okay, Abdu is mudaf and Al-Aziz is mudaf ilah. Mudaf ilah can take al and must be kasra ending. Okay, and then Al-Luwata, this is object, maf'ul bih, must be fatha. Al-Luwata, Abdul Aziz Luwata. Okay, Al-Arabiyya, this is na'at. An'at is adjective, must be the same as the noun described by the adjective. And then wasaqafata is also object. Saqafatal islamiyah, Islamic culture. And then wa wasaqafata, this is conjunction. In Arabic, it is called atof. In Arabic, conjunction is atof. Okay, and Wasaqafat al-Islamiyah and Islamic culture. Okay, next. Abdul Aziz yuhibbu Makkah. Abdul Aziz yuhibbu loves Makkah. Okay, I think you understand the formula. Abdul Aziz is the subject and then you is also the subject. Hibbu yuhibbu means he loves. Abdul Aziz yuhibbu, Abdul Aziz loves Makkata. You start because this is object, or just say Makkah. Okay, next. Wa yaqdi al-waqta sabahan fil jami'ah. Wa yaqdi, we don't need to translate wa, that is not not out of. Okay, this is for beginning of the sentence, to begin the sentence. Okay, so there is no meaning of the wa, and then we begin from yaqdi, he spends. This is a present form. Ya is the subject, he spends. Al-waqta, use waqta because object. Sabahan, okay, is also fatha because it is darfu zaman, adverb of time. Morning, and then fi, in al-jami'ah university. Okay, yaqdil waqta sabahan fil jami'ah, he spends morning time. Morning time is darfu zaman, ya. Fil jami'ah, it means in the morning he is in university. Okay, next. Wa yusalli al-asra wal maghriba wal isha'a fil masjidil haram. Yusalli, he prays. Al-asra, this is the afternoon prayer, asar, and wal maghriba, maghrib, and isha'a. Okay, fi, in al-masjidil haram. Okay, fi is harfu jar, so masjidi, masjidil haram. Al-asra, al-maghriba, and al-isha is the object, so that's why the ending is fatha, ra, ba, and a. Okay, that's the end. Okay, everybody, I think that's all. Don't forget to subscribe my channel, share this video with your friends. Okay, see you. Ma'assalama. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.